Elon Musk wants to explore the far corners of space, and he wants you to come with him. But this fairy tale adventure is heavily dependent on the success of the Starship rocket. A lot has been said about the Starship and how it is the single most crucial project to humanity's daring ambitions in space. You probably already know the number of Raptor engines powering the Starship and the components used to design the body panels of this gigantic spaceship. But we also know that a spaceship that is expected to carry humans to Mars will need much more than efficient engines and robust external structure. So, join us in today's video as we explore how SpaceX and Elon Musk plan to sustain life aboard the Starship space rocket. Right off the bat, Musk has made it clear that the Starship would transport satellites and human passengers alike, and about 100 human passengers per flight to be specific. In the official user's guide released by SpaceX, we got a perfect idea of what the Starship's interior configuration will look like and which amenities will be installed. Some of the things you'll find on board include private cabins, expansive common areas, centralized storage, a viewing gallery, and a solar storm shelter to mitigate the radiation risk involved with space travel. According to a concept design released by the renowned Canadian design engineer Michael Lamontagne, the living space of the Starship will be split into 7 decks labelled A to G. Typically, all decks will be approximately 2.2 metres tall, except for deck G, which would measure only 2.16 metres in height. This should suffice considering that the height of the cabin in the corridor of a Boeing 737 is approximately 2.5 metres, and more importantly, the average height in the United States is 1.7 metres for men and 1.6 metres for women. Critically, Lamontagne adds 2 openings between the decks from bottom to top to mitigate the risk of accidents of travelling through the multiple decks at a go while in zero gravity. In addition, removable rails will be installed around the openings to avoid potential accidents when the Starship is on Earth or on Mars. The rocket will also feature blue bars that will serve as footholds and handholds, similar to the structure of the International Space Station, ISS. The concept design shows hexagonal tiles installed on the floor, which suggests that wall partitions and other items can be attached or removed as required. Amenities like gym, airlock and storage space will also be located on Deck A. Usually, astronauts are mandated to exercise for at least 2 hours while they're on the ISS to prevent bone and muscle loss. We imagine that a similar mandate will be given to space travellers on the Starship. So, technically, engineers would need to install a minimum of 10 units of exercise equipment. And since there's no correct orientation in space, some of these machines could be mounted on weird places, like on walls or ceilings. The airlock is basically an exit route that can be used when engineers need to carry out inspection or repair works outside the spacecraft. It could also help to support landing in places with no pre-existing landing pad. B and C decks are basically the living areas where passengers will be housed. These decks will contain 25 rooms and toilets each, making a total of 50 rooms and bathrooms. Since there will be 100 people on board, each room will most likely be assigned with 2 passengers. Within the rooms, there will be sleeping bags for passengers, similar to what astronauts use on the ISS to prevent them from floating around in zero-G while sleeping. But considering that the Starship isn't as big as the ISS, passengers may be required to sleep in 2 shifts. So, you could be getting your daily dose of exercise while your roommate takes a nap. SpaceX integrates some interesting engineering ideas with the walls, which will be flexible enough to be removed during launch and landing. And speaking about flexibility, passengers will be able to bend the seats into different positions and orientations according to the direction of the rocket. This flexibility also allows for the seats to be removed and stored in the storage space located on the top deck, while extra luggage can be kept in the ceiling of each cabin. Perhaps the most important part of the cabin health-wise will be Deck D, which will house a single toilet and serve as the solar storm shelter. All passengers will be expected to assemble on this deck if a solar storm occurs at any point during the journey. Also, this shelter will act as a part solar shield for other decks and contain a 12.5-centimeter layer of water packed with removable plastic containers. Like the ISS, Starship will have a sophisticated water purification system that will recycle water, sweat, and urine for usage. This process will continue for as long as the mission lasts, helping to keep everyone aboard the spacecraft hydrated. Before we explore other decks down below, if you've enjoyed watching, please like, subscribe, and give us a super thanks if you can. It goes a long way to show your support and helps us produce more interesting content like this one, and to improve on quality even more in future videos. Moving on to the lower decks of the Starship, the last two decks, F and G, will serve as the rocket's entertainment hub with luxury amenities like lounges and giant movie screens. Imagine watching a movie like Interstellar on your way to Mars. Forget about 4D and 5D cinema on Earth. Additionally, these two decks will have large windows, which will give you a premium view of everything that's going on outside the spaceship. From the concept design, you'll agree that the spaceship will be a unique piece of aerospace engineering. But for humans to travel with it, SpaceX will need to install a very good and functional life support system. This system is critical in every space mission because it is the primary and backup components of a spacecraft that address the core needs of human life. It would help regulate and regenerate things like air, water and oxygen, air temperature and pressure. Admittedly, installing a life support system that will be sufficient enough to house 100 passengers on the Starship will significantly increase the ship's weight. Not to mention that there are 7 existing decks and several amenities on board already. This might even cause the design of the rocket to change altogether. But thankfully, Elon Musk seems to have a plan to sort it out. Reacting to questions about the life support system that will be installed on the Starship, Musk said, "I don't think it's actually super hard to do that relative to the spacecraft itself. The life support system is pretty straightforward." SpaceX certainly has some experience in building life support systems for spacecrafts. To be specific, the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft, which has been transporting astronauts to the ISS since 2020, has a functional life support system on board. Although the life support system that will be required for the Starship will be much bigger than the one installed in the Dragon rocket. Perhaps something more robust, similar to the regenerative system that supplies oxygen on the ISS. To make things easier, SpaceX could partner with NASA engineers who have sufficient experience in making large-scale regenerative systems. Initially, Starship's first orbital test flight was scheduled to launch last month, but the time frame has now been moved as the project is yet to receive the necessary clearance. However, Elon Musk estimated that the rocket should be in operation between 1 to 12 months from now. SpaceX has launched 39 orbital missions in 2022 alone, mainly using the Falcon 9 rocket. That's 6 more than the 31 missions that were launched in 2021. However, the aerospace company hopes to extend the limit and launch 100 orbital missions in 2023. So, we can expect to see the Starship rocket hit the skies sometime next year. Thanks a lot for watching the video till the end. Be sure to check out our next highlighted video here for you, and we will see you there.